Namaste, welcome to the online class. Today we are going to study second chapter, that is Boolean algebra. Dear students, you know that computer system works with binary number system. What is binary number system? It is the sequence of zeros and ones. In this chapter, you are going to deal with the algebra called Boolean algebra that deals with binary number system. So, Boolean algebra is used to design the logic gates or logic circuits used by the processors of the computer system. Processors use Boolean algebra to perform arithmetic operations. So, as per the blueprint of final examination, 2 marks 2 question and 5 marks 1 question will be asked for the final examination. Let us begin with the logical variables. What is variable or variables? Variables can store different values during the execution of the program. Here, logical variables means variables that can store truth values. Truth values means either 0 or 1. If the variable store either 0 or 1, it is called logical variables. Logical variables can store truth values. Zero and one. Zero is also called as false. One is called as true. There are three operators in Boolean algebra. We shall discuss one by one. Logical operators. Three operators used in Boolean algebra are AND operator, OR operator, and NOT operator. These are the three operators used in Boolean algebra. First one, AND operator. AND operator performs logical multiplication. Keep in mind, it does not perform logical addition. AND operator performs logical multiplication. Symbol used to represent AND operation is dot. Dot operator or dot symbol is used to represent AND operation. If x and y are the variables, x dot y. If x and y are the variables, it is x dot y. Can be read as x and y. X and y. Next, we shall see the truth table of a AND operator. If x and y are the two variables, x, y. In AND operation, output is x dot y because dot symbol is used to represent AND operator. X and y are the variables, output is x dot y. If there are n input variables, then there should be 2 to the power n combinations of zeros and ones. If there are n input variables, see, in this truth table, you can see 2 input variables x and y. So, n value is 2. For n input variables, there should be 2 to the power n combinations of zeros and ones. 2 to the power n. 2 to the power, value of n is 2. So 2 to the power 2 equal to 4. So in the truth table, there should be 4 combinations of zeros and ones. What are the combinations? 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, 1, 1. 2 zeros, 2 ones. And in the second column, 0, 1, 0, 1. X and Y are the variables. Okay. And output is 0, 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, 1, 0, 0, 1, 1, 1. In AND operation, if any one of the input value is 0, or if both the input values are 0, then output is 0. See, in the first row, both the input values are 0. X input value is 0 and Y input value is also 0. So output is 0. In the second row, X value is 0, Y value is 1. Now, first value is 0. Now, output is 0. In the third row, X value is 1, Y value is 0. So output is 0. But in the fourth row, both the input values are 1. So output is 1. In AND operation, if any one of the input value is 0, or if both the input values are 0, then output is 0. If both the input values are 1, then output will be 1. This is about truth table of a AND operator. X, Y are the variables. Output is X dot Y. X dot Y can be read as X and Y. You can see two variables. Value of N is 2. If there are N variables, then there should be 2 to the power N combinations. 2 to the power N. There are two variables. So 2 to the power 2. Value of N is 2. So there should be 4 combinations of zeros and ones. 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, 1, 1. So in the first row, both the values are 0, output 0. In the second row, first value is 0, output 0. In the third row, second value is 0, output is 0. In the fourth row, both the input values are 1, so output is 1. So truth table, what is truth table? Truth table represents all the possible values of the input variables, that is zeros and ones, with all the possible results, all the possible values of input variables with all the possible results for the given combination of values. See, these are the various combinations of zeros and ones, and you can see the result. This is about AND operator. Next, OR operator. OR operator performs logical addition. OR operator performs logical addition symbol used to represent OR operator is plus. If X, Y are the two variables, X plus Y can be read as X or Y. X or Y. OR operator performs logical addition. Symbol used to represent OR operator is plus. If X and Y are the variables, it can be read as X or Y. If A and B are the two variables, then A plus B can be read as A or B. Next, truth table of OR operator. We shall consider the variables X and Y. X, Y. What is the output in OR operation? It is X plus Y. If the variables are X and Y, output is X plus Y. If the variables are A and B, then output is A plus B. Now, output is X plus Y. Now, you can see two variables in the table. So, there should be 2 to the power 2 combination. 2 to the power 2 is equal to 4. So 4 combinations of zeros and ones. What are the combinations of zeros and ones? 0, 0. Next it is 0, 1. Next 1, 0. Next 1, 1. See, in OR operation, if any one of the input value is 1, or if both the input values are 1, then output is 1. If both the input values are 0, then output is 0. See, in the first row, both the input values are 0. X value is 0, Y value is 0. So, output is 0. In the second row, X value is 0, Y value is 1. One of the input value is 1, so output is 1. In the third row, X value is 1, Y value is 0. So, first input value is 1, so output is 1. In the fourth row, both the input values are 1, so output is 1. So, this is the truth table of a OR operator. So, what is the condition in AND operation? In AND operation, if any one of the input value is 0 or if both the input values are 0, output is 0. In OR operator, if any one of the input value is 1 or both the input values are 1, then output is 1. Next, NOT operator. NOT operator operates on single variable. It operates on single variable. It performs complementation operation. AND operator performs a logical multiplication. OR operator performs logical addition. NOT operator performs complementation. If X is the variable, then complementation of X is X bar. If y is the variable, then complement of y is y bar. Here, symbol used to represent NOT operator is bar or tilde. Bar or tilde. Or complementation of x can also be written as tilde x. Complement of y can also be written as tilde y. So, NOT operator performs complementation. It operates on single variable. We shall see the truth table of NOT operator. It operates on single variable. If X is the variable, complement of X is X bar. If value of x is 0, what is the complement of x bar? If value of x is 0, complement of that value is 1. If value of x is 1, then complement of 1 is 0. So here, NOT operator that operates on single variable, which performs complementation operation. If x is the variable, complement of x is x bar. If y is the variable, complement of y is y bar. If z is the variable, complement of z is z bar. Symbol used to represent NOT operator is bar or tilde. Truth table, x output is x bar. If value of x is 0, value of x bar is 1. If value of x is 1, then value of x bar is 0. So, these are the three operators mainly used in Boolean algebra. So, Boolean algebra is an algebra deals with the binary number system or binary numbers, that is 0 and 1. Okay, next. Evaluation of Boolean expressions. So we have studied three logical operators, and or, not, and performs logical multiplication, or performs logical addition, not performs complementation. Next, evaluation of Boolean expressions. Boolean expressions can be evaluated using precedence rules. What is precedence? Order of the evaluation is called precedence. Means first, not is evaluated first, then and is evaluated, then or is evaluated. This is the precedence of evaluating the Boolean expressions. First, not is evaluated, then and is evaluated, then or is evaluated. If there is parenthesis, then expression within the parenthesis is evaluated first. Precedence means order of the evaluation. So this is the order of the evaluation of Boolean expression. We shall discuss some problems. First problem, x, y, z, x dot y dot z. So in this expression you can see two AND operators. First AND operator, which performs logical multiplication between two variables x and y. Next AND operator performs AND operation between x and y and z. So here you can see three variables. What are the variables? X variable, y variable and z variable. X variable, y variable and z variable. We know that for n input values there should be 2 to the power n combinations of zeros and ones. Here you can see three variables or three input values. So there should be 2 to the power n combinations of zeros and ones. 2 to the power n. Now you can see 3 variables. So n value is 3. So 2 to the power n means 2 to the power 3, that is equal to 8. So in this expression there should be 8 combinations of zeros and ones. 3 variables x, y, z. 8 combinations are 0, 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 1, 1. In the first column, 4 zeros and 4 ones. In the second column, y, 2 zeros, 2 ones. Next again, 2 zeros, 2 ones. Next, in z column, 0, 1, 0, 1, 0, 1, 0, 1. According to the precedence rule, not is evaluated first, but in this expression there is no not operator. You can see two AND operators. So first we need to find out x dot y, x dot y, then x dot y dot z, x and y and z, x and y and z. Okay, we know the rule of AND operation. What is the rule? In AND operation, if any one of the input values is 0, output is 0. If both the input values, or if all the input values are 1, then output is 1. X and y. Now we have to perform AND operation between x and y. So look at the columns x and y. See, first row 0, 0, 0, 0. So what is the output? 0, 0. Output is 0 because both the input values are 0. And in the second row, look at x and y column, second row 0, 0, output is 0. In the third row, 0, 1, again 1 input value is 0, so output is 0. In the fourth row, first input value is 0, second input value is 1, output is 0. Next, 1, 0, second input value is 0, output is 0. Next, 1, 0, output is 0. Next, 1, 1, output is 1. Next, 1, 1, output is 1. Here, both the input values are 1, so output is 1. Even in the previous row, both the input values are 1, so output is 1. Next, x and y, we got x and y column. Next, x and y and z, x and y. Now, look at the fourth column and the third column, x and y and z column, and perform AND operation between these two columns. So first input values 0, 0. We know the rule of AND operation. In AND operation, if both the input values are 0, output is 0. Next, 1, 0, second input value is 0, output is 0. And in the third row, 0. Next, 1, 0, 0. Next, 0, 0, 0. 1, 0, 0, 0, 1. 0, 1, 1, 1. Here, both the input values are 1, so output is 1. So, this type of problem can be asked in the examination. Next problem, evaluation of Boolean expression using truth table. Evaluate the expression x plus yz whole bar using truth table. X plus yz whole bar using truth table. So, in this expression, you can see three variables. What are the variables? X variable, y variable and z variable. Three variables. So, there should be eight combinations of zeros and ones. X, Y, Z. In the first column, 4 zeros. Next, 4 ones. In the second column, 2 zeros, 2 ones. 2 zeros, 2 ones. And in the third column, 0, 1, 0, 1, 0, 1, 0, 1. According to the precedence rule, NOT is evaluated first. Yes, here you can see NOT operator on YZ. Here, dot is missing. If any operator is missing between the variable, it is considered as AND operation. YZ NOT. To find out NOT, we need to find out YZ. YZ means Y and Z. Y and Z, then NOT. Y, Z bar, Y, Z bar. Next, OR operation. Yes, you can see OR operation between X and Y, Z whole bar. So, X, OR, Y, Z whole bar. Now, perform AND operation between Y and Z. Now look at the second column and third column. Yes, in second and third column, both the input values are 0, so output is 0. In the second row, 0, 1. 1 input value is 0. If any one of the input value is 0, output is 0. Next, 1, 0. Yes, the second input value is 0, output is 0. In the fourth row, both the input values are 1, so output is 1. Next, 0, 0, both the input values are 0, so output is 0. Next, 0, 1, first input value is 0, output is 0. Next, 1, 0, first input value is 1, second input value is 0, output is 0. In the last row, both the input values are 1, so output is 1. So, here we have performed AND operation between y and z. We have performed AND operation. Next, yz bar, complement of yz, that is yz bar. Yes, now look at the fourth column yz and apply NOT operation on yz. So, first input value is 0, so output is 1. Next, 0, output is 1. Next, 0, 1. Next, 1, 0, 0, 1, 0, 1, 0, 1, 1, 0. So, NOT performs a complementation. If value of a variable is 0, then output is 1. If the value of the variable is 1, output is 0. Okay. Next, last operation, that is OR operation. Now, it has to be performed between X and YZ whole bar. Now, look at the first column, X column and YZ bar column. X column and YZ bar column, and perform OR operation. 0, 1. In the first row, first value is 0, second value is 1. We know the rule of OR operation. In OR operation, if any one of the input value is 1, then output is 1. See, here YZ whole bar is 1. Second input value is 1, so output is 1. Next, 0, 1. 0, 1. Second value is 1, so output is 1. Next, 0, 1. Second input value is 0, output is 1. Next, 0, 0. Output is 0. Next, 1, 1. Both the input values are 1, output is 1. Next, 1, 1, both the input values are 1, output is 1. Next, 1, 1, both the input values are 1, output is 1. Next, 1, 0, one input value is 1, second input value is 0, output is 1. Okay. If there are 3 variables, there should be 8 combinations. Expressions are evaluated using precedence rule. According to the precedence rule, NOT is evaluated first, then AND is evaluated, then OR is evaluated. Next, another problem. X plus Y into Z bar. X plus Y into Z bar. In previous problem, the expression was X plus YZ whole bar. Now it is X plus Y into Z bar. So there are 3 variables. If there are 3 variables, there should be 8 combinations of zeros and ones. X, Y, Z are the variables. According to the precedence rule, NOT is evaluated first. In this expression, you can see NOT, Z bar, Z NOT. So, find out Z bar. Next, after NOT, AND is evaluated. Y dot Z. Here, dot is missing, but it is considered as AND operation. Y into Z bar. Y into Z bar. And OR is evaluated. Here, you can see OR operator between X and Y into Z bar. So, final term is X plus Y into Z bar. Okay. Now, 8 combinations of zeros and ones are 0, 0, 0, 0. In the first column, 4 zeros, 4 ones. And in the second column, 2 zeros and 2 ones. And in the third column, 0, 1, 0, 1, 0, 1, 0, 1. Next, Z bar, complement of Z. See, third column, Z. Look at the third column, 0, input is 0. What is output Z bar? Z bar is 1. Second row, input is 1, output is 0. Next, 0, 1. Next, 1, 0. Next, 0, 1. Next, 1, 0. Next, 0, 1. 1, 0. Okay, so after z naught, y into z naught or z bar. Now look at the second column and fourth column. Now you have to perform AND operation between variables y and z bar. Operation is AND. Okay, we know the rule of AND operation. What is the rule in AND operation? If any one of the input value is 0 or if both the input values are 0, output is 0. If all the input values are 1, then output is 1. 0, 1. First input value is 0, output is 0. Okay, next 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 1, 1, 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 1, 1, 0, 0. Next, last column is x plus yz whole bar. X plus yz whole, x plus yz bar. Now, you have to perform OR operation between the variables x and y into z bar. Okay, now look at the first column and fifth column. First column and fifth column, we know the rule of OR operation. In OR operation, if any one of the input values is 1 or if all the input values are 1, then output is 1. Okay, 0, 0, 0, next 0, 0, 0, next 0, 1, second input value is 1. Output is 1, next 0, 0, 0, next 1, 0, 1, next 1, 0, 1, next 1, 1, 1, next 1, 0, 1. Okay. Next problem. Fourth problem, evaluate x plus yz whole bar plus z. X plus yz whole bar plus z. Yes, in this expression, there are three variables, x variable, y variable, z variable. Okay, according to the precedence rule, naught is evaluated first. So here naught is applied on yz. So to find out yz naught, we need to find out yz. Yz then y into z then yz bar. Okay. Yz bar. Next AND operation is performed between x and yz bar. So x plus yz whole bar. Okay, next x plus yz whole bar plus z. X plus yz whole bar plus z. So in the first column, 4 zeros, 4 ones. In the second column, 2 zeros, 2 ones, 2 zeros, 2 ones. And in the third column, 0, 1, 0, 1, 0, 1, 0, 1. Okay. Next, AND is performed between Y, Z. So look at the second column and the third column. We know the rule of AND operation. Both the input values are 0, 0. Next, 0, 0, 1, 0, 0, 0, 1. In the last row, both the input values are 1. So, output is 1. Next, YZ whole bar, complement of YZ. 0, 1, 0, 1, Next, 0, 1, 1, 0, 1, 1, 1, 0. Next, x plus yz whole bar. Now, look at the first column and fifth column and perform OR operation between x and yz bar. 0, 1, 1, 0, 1, 1, 0, 1, 1, 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 0, 1. Okay, next x plus yz bar plus z. Now look at the fifth column and third column. Perform OR operation between third column and fifth column, that is between z and x plus yz whole bar. 0, 1, 1, 0, 1, sorry, 1, 1, 1, 0, 1, 1, 1, 0, 1, 0, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 0, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1. So, this is called tautology. What is tautology? Tautology means if the result of the Boolean expression is always true, then it is called tautology. Here, the result is 1. For each row, we got the output 1. That is called tautology. If the result of the Boolean expression is always false, then it is called a fallacy. Fallacy. If the here we got the output 1, that is called tautology. If the result of Boolean expression is always false, that is called fallacy. Tautology. Tautology means if the result of a Boolean expression is always true or 1. Fallacy. Fallacy means if the result of a Boolean expression is always false. If you get all the values are 0, if this is the output, then it is called a fallacy. In this problem, we have got output 1 for each row, that is called a tautology. If all the values are equal to 0, then it is called fallacy. Okay. Next, last problem. A fifth one. Expression is A into B bar plus C plus C bar. A into B bar plus C plus C bar. So you can see three variables. What are the variables? A, B, C. A, B, C are the three variables in the problem. So three columns. A column, B column, C column. And in the first column, 4 zeros, 4 ones. And in the second column, 2 zeros, 2 ones. Next, 0, 0, 1, 1. in the third column 0 1 0 1 0 1 0 1. Yes, according to the precedence rule, not is evaluated first, then and is evaluated, then or is evaluated. If there is parenthesis, then expression within the parenthesis is evaluated first. Here you can see two brackets, but innermost parenthesis is B bar plus C, B bar plus C. So here find out B bar, okay, then B bar plus C, B bar plus C, B bar plus C, B bar plus C. Next we need to find out C bar, because OR operation has to be performed between B bar plus C and C bar. So before that we have to find out C bar. Next B bar plus C plus C bar, expression within the parenthesis, B bar plus C plus C bar, B bar plus C plus B bar plus C plus C bar, and final expression or in the final or in the last column A and B bar plus C, B bar plus C, A and B bar plus C plus C bar. So this is the final expression, okay. A, B, C, first find out B bar. Look at the second column, that is B, find out complement of B. Yes, complement of 0, 1, next 1, next 0, next 0, next 1, next 1, next 0, next 0. Okay, next B bar plus C. Now OR operation is to be performed between B bar and C. Now look at the third column and fourth column, B bar and C, perform OR operation between B bar and C. We know the rule of OR operation: if any one of the input value is 1, output is 1. Okay, 1 1 1 0 0 0 1 0 1 0 1 1 1 1 1 0 0 0 0 0 0 1 0 1 1 1 0 1 1 0 1 1 1 0 1. Okay, next C bar. Now look at the third column and perform complementation of C. C bar, yes, complementation of C. 0 1 1 0, next 0 1, next 1 0, next 0 1, next 1 0, next 0 1, next 1 0. Next B bar plus C, B bar plus C plus C bar, perform OR operation between B bar plus C and C bar. Now look at the sixth column and fifth column, fifth column and sixth column, B bar plus C and C bar, perform OR operation between these two columns. Yes, 1 1 1 1 0 1 0 1 1 1 0 1 1 1 1 1 0 1 0 1 1 1 0 1. Okay, the last expression A into B bar plus C plus C bar. Now we have to perform AND operation between the variable A and B bar plus C plus C bar. Now look at the first column and seventh column. Perform AND operation between these two columns, first column and seventh column. Now we have to perform AND operation, A dot B bar plus C plus C bar. We know the rule of AND operation. If any one of the input values is 0, or if all the input values are 0, output is 0. 0, 1, 0, 1, 0. Next, 0, 1, 0. Next, 0, 1, 0, 0, 1, 0. 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1. 1 1 1 1 1 1. So if there are 3 input variables, there should be 8 combinations. If there are 2 input variables, then there should be 4 combinations. For example, if the expression is x plus x y bar. So in this expression you can see 2 variables. What are the variables? X and Y. If there are 2 variables, 4 combinations of zeros and ones. So 0, 0. In the first row 0, 0. 1, 1. Second row 0, 1. 0, 1. Next, go for not Y bar, then and X into Y bar, then or X plus X Y bar. Okay, x, y, first find out y bar. Y 0 1 1 0 0 1 1 0. Next, perform AND between x and y bar. 0 1 0 0 0 0 1 1 1 1 0 0. Last expression, x plus x y bar. Now we have to perform OR operation between x and x y bar. So look at the first column and fourth column, perform OR operation. 0, 0, 0. Next, 0, 0, 0. Next, 1, 1, 1. Next, 1, 0, 1. If there are 2 input variables, there should be 4 combinations. If there are 3 input variables, there should be 8 combinations of zeros and ones. Okay, we shall continue in the next class.